Hey guys, welcome back to JaRyCu Builds Stuffz, episode number 10. It's been a couple weeks since I filmed that last episode. I got sucked into Sky Factory 3, and oh my goodness. I have been playing and playing and playing and playing and playing and breeding chickens and basically I've renamed that series Chicken Factory. Because my chickens are running everything. I've got chickens running an extreme reactor. I've got chickens running lava reactors or lava generators. I mean, you name it, it's been done. But I've also done a lot here on the Builder's Custom Mod Pack. So I'd like to show you some of the stuff we've gotten done. And then, time permitting, we're going to build some stuff. Because, you know, this is the Builder's Custom Pack. So first things first, last episode was a world tour. And not much has changed in the world since then, but let's go out and take a look. I haven't been on the server in a couple days, so it might be a couple new things, and oh my goodness. There's a windmill. I didn't build this. There's a windmill and a house that both look really, really, really good. One of my old buddies I met when I hosted the Infinity Expert server a year and a half ago has gotten on here with us. And I encouraged him to help us build the city out. So build the city out he has. Look at this. This looks amazing. I'll go back and add the pathways in the right way for him, I think. But let's take a look at it really quick. Let's get my sword out in case there's anything in here. Okay, mob free. Man, this guy is good. Look at this. I'm going to take some lessons from him. I don't know what this is going to be. I guess it's going to be his house. This must be his little stash. Kind of like I put chest up when I'm building stuff. We can go in here pretty safely. Oh, come on. Yeah, I've got this living armor. I'll tell you more about that in a minute. Okay, that's... He must be storing stuff in there. Let's go and take a look upstairs. Hey, he's got a little bit of power going on. I'll have to see about throwing in some wireless power, depending on how he's doing it. Because we've got some power also. We need to upgrade our power too. I haven't done that yet. Man, check this out. That is, what, an explosive generator. I can't believe he went that route too. But TNT is pretty easy to come by in this world. Okay, he's also using this for power, I see. I wonder, is that generating triple the power or not? I don't know. I've never seen anybody do a windmill three times over like that. That is so cool. Yeah, this is my friend Effie, E-F-I. That's not his full name, but I don't give out the whole name unless it's like JC and they made the pack, so you needed to look for it. That is so cool, though. We've had a little mystery going on here for about a week of disappearing horses. Remember we had like 7 or 8 horses during the tour? Well, we're missing a bunch of them. They just disappeared. Don't know where they went. The chicken. This is our town chicken, by the way. This is not a chicken factory chicken. This is the town chicken. We can come back over here so I don't shoot him. But he literally just stays in town and wanders around. I need to give him a name tag. Is there any in here? Let's see. Nope, I didn't bring any name tags. But yeah, the horses are... This is a wild horse. This is one we bred. But all the horses just disappeared on us. Don't know where they went. Thank you for the egg, buddy. Oh, nope. Didn't get nothing out of that, though. But I did build something back here before I started on the major project. Why is there a cow at it? We now have a city park. So this is the city park. I blended a bunch of the different things here. Like these are all 4 corners have a custom tree in it. That's why they're all the same size and shape. These blocks here, both the wall, this and this, all right, let's see, those are all from Batania. So this is white Portuguese pavement. These are metamorphic cobblestone. And this is metamorphic cobblestone wall. The plains version, so they're kind of greenish. I grew the grass up intentionally. It was all mowed down because I leveled all this off. Do I have... Yes. Let's catch some Z's really quick. Because I don't want zombies and creepers out here. We haven't secured everything yet. Need to light it up some more. Okay. So yeah, but we got a city park out here now. I'm probably going to come back and put some benches down. Because it does need that. But each entrance has a light. These are from the ATL Craft Candles mod. ATL Craft Candles. And they're just really cool looking. I don't know if they're light sources because I don't leave at night because there's just too much stuff here to leave at night. But yeah, I'll put little chisel blocks down in there. Made this entire thing. And it's something that I hope looks pretty good. You'll have to let me know in the comments what you think about it. But I really, really like it. We have a temporary cactus farm over here because I needed some green dye. So this is not permanent. I'll get a permanent spot for it later, but we had an empty lot, so I just stuck it on there. And we had a guy playing for a couple of days who got into the Psy mod, but then he never came back. So I'll probably give him another week or so before I reappropriate this lot because I do want to do something here. I haven't decided what yet, though. I may do like a little pond or the river, or a creek, I should say. Run the creek under the road, which could be pretty cool. We'll see how that goes. Forestry farm's still there. Let's go out here and look at the big project. And then I got another project I'll show you that I did. Now this is... I've never played with blood magic before. I've attempted it, but never gotten very far with it. Until now. And let me tell you, blood magic is awesome. Let's see, how are we doing over here? This is my divination sigil. 1.1 million LP on autopilot. Yeah, you hear the crushing sound, right? That's a cursed earth farm down there from Extra Utilities 2. I'm trying to see if you can see anything. You see all the loot left down there. I'm not even bothering to get the loot out of it. But yeah, there's a cursed earth farm. Then all these colorful ritual stones make up the Well of Suffering, which the master ritual stone is attached to the altar right there. So this gives us automatic LP. When I started this, this tier and this tier were basically nothing but self-sacrifice runes. So I had to constantly, prick myself here, then go over here and recharge my dagger. You see how it's doing it right now. You wait for the little flame to go off. This is called a Tranquility Altar, by the way. The wooden path, so everything from here to there to there to there. This top layer is level 1. This is level 2 with the stone brick path. And so I've got lava on it. And over here I've got essence. That's literally my blood in there. Level 3 is the one down here with the worn stone path. And level 4 is the obsidian brick path over here. And all this stuff comes together, let me show you up here. It's not maximized like I saw on Reddit, but it's pretty close. To give me a 272% bonus for pricking myself. That's a whole lot of LP. So I was flying back and forth and back and forth. And just doing my thing. Prick myself, let this thing go. Go back and forth to make runes and all that. Well, now I don't have to. Let me see, we're getting tons of LP out of this. I mean, we were sitting on 116 when we flew over here. We're already 124. This is a gigantic ritual stone. Let's take a look. That's the Archmage Blood Orb. So this thing does wonders. I'll throw it back in there. So I've got a Blood Magic Backpack. Let me see all the stuff we've done up here already. Got a bunch of stuff going on. Let's see. I made the sentient armor and then traded it in because I've got better armor now. Got more blank slates. We've got blood lamps now. You see on top of the tier 4 portion of this, that little, I don't know what you call it, plume. That's actually a lamp. That's the blood magic light. Kind of like the flashlight wand or the Batania lights. That's the blood magic lights. I really like that. We may start doing Batania pretty soon too. I found an amazing quarry that mixed Batania with blood magic. Somebody posted it to Reddit last week, and it blew my mind. It involved calling meteors from the sky and then having pulse mana spreaders break it down and having hopper hawks pick it up. So my goal right now is to get to tier 6. I have all the runes down for tier 6. I'm going to change them out, obviously, with more capacity runes. Because we have a capacity of... Oh, I forgot it. Works differently now. It doesn't save it. We've only got a capacity of 84,000. I want to get that capacity up some more. We've got plenty of room to work with. I want some more speed runes down to make things even faster. And I've got to get rid of these self-sacrifice ones. Now, what these two chests do is... This chest is for input. So I can throw like those blank slates I had, or I can throw smooth stone, which I don't have on me right now. Yeah, we can throw some in here. Let's let this thing build up just a hair. And I'll show you what this does. We'll throw like three of them in. I just want to make sure there's enough blood in here first to do it. Okay, it's got six. What are you set to? You don't pull stone out. So what you do is you throw them in here. They get pulled out. They get stuck in here. This conduit is set for a redstone signal with this on. I changed this to green just so I could see the arrows better. There's no reason for the color outside of that. The way this works is it holds everything in inventory until it's completely done crafting, until there's nothing left to craft. Then it releases it, and the conduit can pull it, and it sticks it over here. Now we've got more blank slates. So that's how that works. Pretty cool, huh? Let's see here. We'll throw those up here. So we've got that going on for us. But this has been a ton of fun. I had no idea how much fun this was. Getting the nether stars to make the beacons was a nightmare. We tried at the... My first wither you saw a couple of episodes ago from the series. And that was my very first wither ever doing it the vanilla way. Where I went up and I got up to bedrock and the nether. And we took it out. It killed me 4 or 5 times and bam, good to go. Well, somebody on the server thought we could do it better in the overworld, so we went to the bottom of the mines over here at spawn. And I'm going to show you this as we go. But we went to the bottom of the mines over here and put him here in the overworld. And it was me and two other players. And I didn't realize we were doing it like right then. So we didn't have an escape tunnel. We didn't have a lot of stuff done. We didn't have any potions. Didn't have any milk on us. And all of a sudden, the wither was out. And let's just say it was not the most fun experience of my life. Okay, they filled in most of it, looks like. Or was it here? Did we get farther back? That's where it was. Okay, they filled in a lot of the damage. But I was at the Tier 4 Blood Altar. This entire cave was blown apart. I'm talking going down. You could see the bedrock. It was so far blown apart. And I'm betting we died. Let's see. How do you see? Under E? Yeah. Leaderboards. Number of deaths. You see me with 34 deaths? I probably got at least a third of those fighting that wither. That was not the most fun I've ever had. I honestly didn't think we were going to be able to take it out. Whoa, don't know where that came from. So it was an experience, to say the least. But I ended up going into creative mode, since I'm an admin on the server, and just taking it out so it couldn't hurt me. It felt really cheaty, but I'm like, there's got to be a better way. So I remembered a guy named Softworker, who is now... No, he's not in our group. He's a German guy. And he made a video that I watched back when I was still doing the Unstoppable series about how to use an RFTools shield, what do you call it, a force field, to kill a wither. And he combined it with the actual additions, had the whole thing automated, so it made the wither for him. I mean, it was really cool the way he did it. So I'm like, we don't have actual additions in here, so mine won't be that complicated, but I bet we could do it anyway. So, you remember back when we first started, somebody built one half, I think it's right where we're standing actually, one half of the transporters from RFTools. He never bothered to build the rest of them. So I took the ones he had because I had those in storage, just waiting to see if he'd come back, and I put them up here. And we now have another wither room. So we're going to dial this one time. Let's go down there. Excuse me. Okay, we're down to the nether. Okay, and I did some Batania decoration in here. It's not the prettiest thing. That's another portal. So I didn't have to go all the way back to show you that, but I wanted to. Just so you can see that. This room here. Okay, just making sure I can get out of it. It's a trash can. Okay, on off switch. That's a restored spawner to get wither skeleton heads. So you come over here. JC built this. You get the wither skeleton heads from here. You got to be careful because these things are lightning fast, and it does spawn regular skeletons too. So it's not quite as good as a powered spawner, but it's free. It takes no RF. It takes a little bit of GP. So it's got its pros and cons. But then you come over here, get yourself some soul sand from somewhere in the nether, walk through the interesting green choice I made the other night. Apparently I needed more sleep because this doesn't look very good. And then you have this area here. And you don't see anything, right? Bam, nothing here. It's nice and plain. Well, it's actually not. There's a force field there. Exactly. And the way I've got this guy working, this is the shield generator. And you choose the color, and I've got it set to be redstone on. Any hostile that gets in there, the shield will be solid and give it damage, only for hostiles. So if I'm in here, it doesn't matter. See, I can be in here all I want to. It doesn't hurt me at all. It doesn't hurt any players at all. If I wanted to, I could set it so it could hurt certain players, it could hurt no players, blah, blah, blah. Anything I wanted, I could do. This is an RFTools power cell. I have this is wireless power, kind of like a tesseract or like a dimensional transceiver, except it's a lot easier to make, and it's just better. Like this one will do 5,000 RF per tick, and holds 2 million RF. So I built a 25 million, the vibrant capacitor, and I stuck it at spawn. Not at spawn, at the power area, power station. And when we tested this thing out, I didn't know about these because I hadn't seen them yet. I didn't even know they existed. So we brought the capacitor down here and just stuck it on top. And it worked. That 25 million RF got us like 7 wither kills. In fact, should I demonstrate this for y'all? Would y'all like to see it? Because I've got, let's see if I got my cleaver. I do have my cleaver. I got my magnet. Let's show you how this thing works, because it's really, really simple. And I could probably use another nether star. Let's get all the stuff off my toolbar so I don't accidentally hit it. We'll keep this food over here too. Okay. We'll show you how this thing works, because it's really, really simple. Let's go get some wither skeleton heads first. Now, this part I've not used, so it kind of frightens me, but we'll see. Let's turn on the magnet. Let's make sure we're full up on health. Okay. Nope, Andy's already hit me. Brilliant. You have to be careful of that. Let's refill just a little bit. Luckily, I've got this blood magic armor on. I didn't show you yet. It's the living set. And look at all the upgrades I've already gotten. So I'm healthy, so I'll get extra health. I've got all kinds of stuff in here. I didn't realize I could upgrade it. So it's got, in yellow, 100 upgrade points. I saw a video where a guy had 300 upgrade points. I don't know how he got it. So that part I'm going to figure out probably today, because I'm going to play on this server a lot today. But I want a lot more upgrades. I can take upgrades off of this. Let's go back in here and kill some stuff. It even helps my bow and arrow out. I'm gonna stand back just a hair here. Ah, really, dude? Come on, give me some Give me what I want. Okay, there we go. There we go. Come on now. I've got a really good chance of beheading on this thing. I should be getting some skulls out of this. Just gonna make sure we don't die. I think we're in a good spot standing right here. You see what I mean about them being psycho? Flip that off for a second. Did we get, we got two, we need one more. You know, let's clear some of this out. Don't need this on me. Put that up. I really need to get an ender bag so I can just throw all this stuff into my storage automatically. I don't know why I haven't done that yet. Those will come in handy if I want to make some more cursed hearth farms. The rest of that will be good. Okay. One more skull. That's all we need, guys. Cooperate with me. Because it helps if I let the sword fully recharge, right? This is also a good way to level up your tools, your weapons. Come on over, buddy. Come on over. Both of y'all, come on over. Woo, you got me. Good shot, buddy. Good shot. All right, we got three. Oh, you think you got me. Now, one of the enchantments that my armor has on it lets it fire multiple arrows out, which I think is really, really cool. Okay, we're going to leave those arrows out there because we don't need them. Get rid of these swords because they're stone swords and I really don't care. Anything else I don't want? Keep the bones. Keep those for now because I haven't made the sigil of the harvest yet. And I need to see about getting a shovel. I need a little more. Do I have any soul sand? Oh, I do have soul sand on me. Okay. So let's go over here. Get over this. There's no door in here because it shouldn't be necessary. Let's drink up. Make sure my health is all the way up. And I'm going to show you how this guy works. So what you want to do is you're going to be right here next to the lever. And take another look at it so you know where it is. I basically cut out the netherrack to fit the shield. So you don't want to put it on the edge because the wither does turn to the side and it can get out if you do that. You want to put him right in the middle. So you can't put it through the shield. You have to turn the shield off. So you do it like this. Okay, you got those down? You make sure you can see that thing because it is pretty fast. 1, 2, 3, on. Now, you don't take damage, but I always stand back anyway. Because when he explodes, it's still kind of loud. Come on, buddy. Come on. Pop. And see, he can't get out. And look at his health. It's just going and going and going. It does use a lot of power. But that power, it's getting replenished from our power bank outside. So that's pretty cool. This gives us free nether stars. Basically free, I mean, we're not doing anything. So I'm loving this. This is really, really cool. Bam. Dead. And the nether star disappeared. Wonderful. Oh, no, it's on me. Okay, I didn't see that I grabbed it. Now, if you're playing like with immersive engineering like we are, you can change this to be player damage. You'll get more drops from it. You'll get other bonus drops. But it costs a lot more power. And honestly, all I want is nether stars, so I don't see the point. Now, nether stars in this pack can be used for a lot of stuff. You can make advanced wand cores, which means you can make like capturing wands, you can make acceleration wands. These are all wands that we have, so that's not necessary, but let's see. A witherless rose. That could come in handy for fighting skeletons. Fertilescence. Okay, we can get some of that. Of course, you can make beacons with it. Quantum core for advanced solar panels. Huh. I think I remember making that in Infinity Expert. Silk quarries. if we needed a quarry, we could use that. We could upgrade the shield projector, which just means it holds more power and does more damage. It's not really necessary. Dragon egg mill. Nether star generators. You know, general stuff. Over 2 minutes, it generates 9.6 million RF. Blood altar. That's how I got my Archmage blood orb. So that's pretty cool. We can turn this into a Grand Tartaric gem, which we may end up having to do. I don't know what... I see. So we can use this for blood magic in there, too. We can also get a tome of Alkahelts free, because I've got a ton of redstone. And we can double this. Although, honestly, it's easier just to come down here and do it like this. So you can see there's all kinds of stuff you can do with it. It's also, you make the interdimensional upgrades for refined storage. So there's a lot of stuff you can do with this in this world. For now, we're going to throw it up here. Okay, so that's pretty cool. Is there anything else in the Nether? I think that's all we've done so far. Yeah, because I haven't really explored the Nether too much because I haven't needed to, because everything we need is right here. This is going to have to go, though. I'm hating this now. The other night, I must have been just sleep-deprived looking at it. Let's go back to the house. JaRyCu, dial once. So I'm going to set these portals up for the mob farm, too. I'll just have to ask JC where to put it. Speaking of which, let's go take a look at his mob farm. Because he has upgraded that thing like you wouldn't believe, even past what you saw last time. So let's go take a look at that really quick. By the way, if you're liking the episode in the series, hit that like button so I know you like it. Leave me some comments. Go ahead and subscribe because you know you want to see more. And also, share this out with other people. This is more of a niche-type series for builders. This is not, you know, all-out modded Minecraft. Look at this, by the way. He's bricked it all the way down. That's tons and tons of clay he had to get. The doors, the lights. I mean, he spent so much time down here. Just look at this. This thing is so beautiful. You saw this last time. Just the details is what I want to show off, though. Because he did such a good job with this. Uh-oh, he's added more. First, down here is where the actual killing area is. So down here we've got an XP thing, where he just stores his XP so he doesn't lose it in case he dies. This is the kill shoot, where you stand here with your bow or your sword or your cleaver or whatever. You can tell it gets used. There's 220 zombie heads in there, on top of what we've already pulled out. Some stuff in here. I'm going to keep my necrotic bones because I can add those onto things. So I've got one on here. That's necrotic is lifesteal. So if you hit something, it gives you some life back. That's one way I didn't die when we were fighting the wither skeletons. He's apparently taking some of the armor out because this thing was full of armor the other day. But I want to see where the back tunnel goes. Is it just a mine or what is this? Because this wasn't here. Okay, that's... Is he building more? Oh, I see what he's doing. He was asking the other night about... I guess that is what he's doing. Okay, I bet he's building a blaze farm in here. Or some sort of farm anyway. Yeah, because see, those push out, knock you down. Okay, oh, this is what he's talking about. Okay, I know what he's doing. This is a crusher. So he's going to have stuff spawn up there and knock it down to here. And then crush it down to half a heart. So you can just whack it with stuff and get the XP for your tools. It'd also be a quick XP farm for you, but that's going to be really cool when he gets that done. So yeah, that's a teaser. Come back later. I don't know if he'll finish this today or not. Typically on Sundays, he's out and about doing stuff. But yeah, check back in later and we'll see about showing you that off too. But that's where the builder server stands right now. I hope you enjoyed this update. And I know it's been way too long in the making. But this is definitely a server that's a long-term thing. So this won't get tons of updates like Sky Factory does. This one they get like an episode or two every week. Just because it takes a while to build stuff. But guys, outside of that, I think that's going to be it for this episode. It's about that time, so... Oh yeah, I will show you this. My garden house got demolished. As best as we can figure, lightning hit it and just burned down half of it. And I haven't gone back and rebuilt it yet. That just happened a couple days ago. So I'm going to go back and redo the inside of it. Probably move those bookcases. I didn't even know it took out the hole back here. It must have got hit again. Because the bottom wasn't damaged like that. That's sad. But yeah, lightning took out about half of it. So that's the disadvantage of building with wood. So I'm going to go back and fix this sooner or later. Yeah, guys, that's it. Thanks for coming out today, and I will see you next time.